What is up, everybody? So, do you want to become a software engineer? Now, do you want to spend, I don't know, between $20,000 and $150,000 on a 4-year degree or dev bootcamp to become one? Or would you rather take advantage of some affordable online tools for maybe like $50 or $100 a month? And guess what? You can still achieve the same result of a 6-figure earning software engineer. Now, don't worry, I'm not trying to sell you any courses and there's no ads in this video. Now, later in this video, I'm going to tell you how to be a successful self-taught developer. But before I do that, I'm gonna share you my personal journey of how I started 6 years ago. Now, back at the ripe age of 24 years old, I worked in finance and I hated it. And I don't use the word often, but I really did hate it because the work was not very intellectual stimulating. I was basically doing spreadsheets all day with PowerPoints as well, and then just a lot of long, wasteful meetings. And I realized, like, I can't do this for the next 20 to 30 years. I was basically a cubicle monkey and I didn't know what to do. Now, one day I had a drink with a friend and he's been a software engineer for about 2 years at a time. And he's talking about all the great perks, all the amazing benefits, great lifestyle. He's proud of what he's building and things like that. And I looked over at him and I was like, wow, this guy is really passionate about something. He's making good money. He has good perks and he's just enjoying his life. And guess what? A few years ago, he was a college dropout and he worked some office assistant job, right? So I was like, well, if he could do it, then I could do it as well. Now, after a few months of that conversation, I basically committed to becoming a software engineer. And it took me about a year to get my first job. Based on my experience, I can tell you 3 things that can help you to become a self-taught developer. Number one, everybody cares about what you can do, not what software engineering degree or what bootcamp you came from, right? So think about it this way. If I were to hire you today, right, I just want to make sure, one, that you can push quality code, that you're easy to work with, that you're collaborative, and that when things get tough, or maybe there's a tight deadline, or there's a tough bug to fix, that you can fix it. I don't really care which degree you got, which bootcamp you went to for that. Now, having a 4-year degree or going to bootcamp definitely helps you get in some of these skills, but also there's a ton of information available online, right? Now, this brings me to my second point, is that there's a lot of affordable resources online available at places like Udemy, YouTube, Coursera, Udacity, Codecademy, and there's so many more. One thing that did not work for me is those boring computer science textbooks, like especially those R-Rally ones. They're so dry and boring. I don't know, like if you ever need to go to sleep, just, you do not need any medicine, just read a few pages of those boring ass textbooks and you'll be able to fall asleep within a few minutes. Like, so you do need to find your personal learning style. Of course, it's a little easier if you have an instructor in the classroom basically and they go over the problems with you. However, it's just a lot less expensive if you teach yourself how to code. And that brings me to my third point, and that's just a lot less expensive if you use the online tools available to teach yourself how to code. So how much do these tools cost, right? So let's go over the details. Let's say you join a website like Team Treehouse, which costs about $25 a month, right? And there you could learn front-end, back-end development and other things like that. So it's $25 for 12 months. Then you have Lead Code, which is, let's say you want to learn algorithms for your interviews and things like that. That's about $35 a month. Now let's also consider you join Udacity, which has career tracks on all kinds of development, data science, anything like that. So those for 4 months, they're typically around $1,200. And then let's say you buy more books or more courses for another $500, right? So the total of that will be about $2,420, right? Over the course of a year. And I'm being generous here, right? Now, how much does a 4-year degree cost? Let's say it's between $10,000 and $40,000 per year. So for 4 years, that's between $40,000 and $160,000. Now that is a lot of money. And it's also, you take a lot of courses that don't directly benefit your career. Now, think about that. Now, how much does a bootcamp cost? Now they offer different payment methods and things like that, but on average, it's between about $15,000 and $20,000, right? So you typically go do a full-time bootcamp for about 3 to 4 months, and then you start applying to jobs and hopefully you get hired. Now guess what? What a lot of those companies don't tell you is that typically it takes 3, 6, 9 months after you graduate to get a job. Like, you're not really guaranteed a job in the first place, but assuming you work hard and do everything right, like it'll take you 3 to 9 months to find that job. Let's say you have to quit your job in order to join that bootcamp. Now we all come from different circumstances, right? So let's say your job, you're making anywhere between $30,000 and $120,000 a year in income. So on top of the bootcamp cost of $15,000 to $20,000, you have to also consider the amount of time that you're not making money. that's also a huge cost and a huge factor. Now, being a self-taught developer is not easy, but trust me when I say this, with enough hard work and dedication, you got this. Now let's go.